very interesting because of this feature. Cloaks me in shadows of a tumbling down. Crouch. Darkness, it seems. What it could have been is not shadows, but an enemy nearby. Look at the item itself. Not one I normally go for. Yeah. Any enemy that gets too close takes 5 points of poison damage per second. That added with his generation of the arguments is pretty nice. You kind of should slow down any attacks. Skeletons. Well, that is one good warning that this armor has. If I'm just walking and all of a sudden I get cloaked in shadow, there's an enemy nearby. Also might want to be careful. I need to test this thing out. Does not appear to be harming the horse.
Now!
this excess weight. Southern side or border side? Border side last time. When I ran into those casters. skeleton first, and then two random encounters. This can be one of the bad things. Copper takes so long to get back to some of your houses, which makes it a good idea to have more than one house.
now, ain't this a surprise? Much easier to rob when you're dead.
To heavy or dungeon work or bandit raids. So far, with the chicken. This will be a real test.
Disrespect the law, and you disrespect me.
It requires them to actually go to have aggro against me. Or I collect aggro from them. That means I don't have to worry as much.
I'm on my way to Windhelm to join up with the Stormcloaks. Ulfric has the right of it.
Yeah, he's going in the opposite direction. Into a cave bear. Try to run as if it were a Fallout 4. Not Skyrim.
Let me guess. Someone's...
Algrif won't give us a straight answer.
He's a true Nord. He'll come around.
Don't be so sure of that. We've intercepted couriers from Solitude. The Empire's putting a great deal of pressure on Whiterun.
And what would you have me do?
If he's not with us, he's against us.
He knows
that. The Stormcloaks are finding victory across the land.
How long are you going to wait?
You think I need to send Balgruuf a stronger message?
If by message you mean shoving a sword through his gullet.
Taking his city and leaving him in disgrace would make a more powerful statement, don't you think?
So we're ready to start this war in earnest, then?
Soon.
I still say you should take them all out like you did Dead King Torig.
Torig was merely a message to the other Jarls. Whoever we replace them with will need the support of our armies.
We're ready when you are.
Things hinge on Whiterun. If we can take the city without bloodshed, all the better. But if not...
The people are behind you.
Many, I fear, still need convincing.
Then let them die with their false kings.
We've been soldiers a long time. We know the price of freedom. But people are still weighing things in their hearts.
What's left of Skyrim to wager?
They have families to think of.
How many of their sons and daughters follow your banner? We are their families.
Well put, friend. Tell me, Galmar, why do you fight for me?
I'd follow you into the depths of oblivion. You know that.
Yes, but why do you fight? If not for me, what then?
I'll die before elves dictate the fates of men. Are we not one in this?
I fight for the men I've held in my arms, dying on foreign soil. I fight for their wives and children whose names I heard whispered in their last breath.
The Stormcloaks are finding victory across the land.
I fight for the few who did come home, only to find our country full of strangers wearing familiar faces. I fight for my people. Impoverished to pay the debts of an empire too weak to rule them, yet brands them criminals for wanting to rule themselves! I fight so that all the fighting I've already done hasn't been for nothing. I fight because I must.
Your words give voice to what we all feel, Ulfric. And that's why you will be High King. But the day words are enough will be the day when soldiers like us are no longer needed.
I would gladly retire from the world, were such a day to dawn.
Aye, but in the meantime, we have a war to plan.
Only the foolish or the courageous approach a Jarl without summons. Do I know you? Ah, yes. Destined for the chopping block, if I'm not mistaken. A fair point. Well, you've come to the right place then. Speak with Galmar. I'm always looking for able fighters. Not everyone can say they made it out of Helgen. Seems we're all branded villains these days. So long as your criminal past stays in the past, and you fight for me with honor and integrity, we'll welcome you into our ranks.
Aye. But in the meantime, we have a war to plan. Helgen, eh? Ulfric told us quite the story. If you made it through all that, you're likely worth something to me. But first, tell me, why does a lizard want to fight for Skyrim? Fair enough, but are you willing to die for your home? All right. But before I can put you to use, I need to know how much you can take. I have a little test for you. That's what I like to hear. So long as you can back up those words with steel. I'm sending you to Serpentstone Island. If you survive, you pass. If you die, well, you weren't going to be much use to me anyway. Watch yourself out there.
There's no glory in war. It's just something they tell soldiers so they'll risk their lives.
If it's better board you're after, Kanderhurst Hall's got both. Those Whiterun guards can take down a dragon, so can we.
It didn't advance the plot line. because I had gotten out of the conversation instead of asking.
Don't be so sure of that. We've intercepted couriers from Solitude. The Empire's put... Are you ready for Serpentstone Island? It's where men have tested their metal for ages. There's a strange rock formation built by the ancients. Something about that place attracts the Ice Wraiths. You kill an Ice Wraith out there, and I'll have all the proof I need about you. We'll see about that, won't we?
And what would you have me do?
If he's not with us, he's against us.
Heard about you and your honeyed words. To wonder, what does the Dragonborn do once he's summoned by the Greybeards?